All right, if you could tell me your name, please.
Janelle Ellis.
Janelle, where are you from?
Dallas.
And what do you do in Dallas?
I have been a college teacher for 40 years at a downtown college. I teach American Lit, critical thinking on current issues, freshman comp.
All right, and what brings you to Denver?
I am here because this is my fourth national convention. I went in 76, 80, 88, and then this is my fourth. I was a Hillary delegate to the Texas State Convention. I've been a delegate to every state convention since 76. I'm a political activist, a precinct chairman, and a crusader for, particularly for women candidates.
And in terms of Hillary Clinton's experience and for the women who supported her, where do you think her female supporters are right now in terms of absorbing the results?
We're having a very, very hard time becoming enthusiastic for the ticket. Most of my friends and of all of my associates in political activism, and we were all on the team for Hillary, are at different stages. I only know one person who is totally enthusiastic about the ticket.
Do you know anybody who will not vote for Obama?
Are about the same as CNN's, about 27%. About a fourth are going to vote for Obama. They were going to vote for Hillary, however, if she had been named vice president.
Okay.
They would have been totally on the ticket had she been the VP.
All right. So what do you think is causing all this? Because we haven't really seen a candidate whose supporters have been so supportive of that candidate that they have a hard time transferring it to the winner.
I have tried to explain to my son there is a deep chasm, a deep cultural gulf, a generational gulf between Hillary and Obama, the supporters. We have worked all of our lives, women my age, to get a woman ready for the presidency, primed, and we found the perfect person in Hillary. Hillary was perfect. We probably won't live to see another. This is not going down well with us.
And you don't see anybody to succeed.
No, because Hillary was perfect. Hillary is perfect. I mean, it's not that we had any reservations. I don't want to cry and ruin my bed. I mean, she's got a resume that I can't think of any man in the Senate or in public office with the background that Hillary has. In 62, when I graduated from college, the doors weren't open. See, it took another 10 years to get doors open for law school, medical school. So Hillary is that first boomer bunch, and she's tough. We believe that she loves Bill, but she might not. she toughed it out,
right.
And he's pretty cute. And we think he's cute, and we think she thinks she's cute. You know, but it's okay. It's okay. That wasn't it's a problem with men, though, that she...
Okay.
And the fact that she reminds men of their fifth grade teacher or their first wife across the divorce table, you know, she reminds them of a tough... she's tough. You know, we need to be tough.
Right.
But she's also very complex. She's witty. She got prettier and prettier. You know, I mean, she didn't even Chris Matthews, that viper, that hissing viper, who, you know, now there's a whole group of professional women, bring me the head of Chris Matthews, trying to get him fired. You know, knew that news. Bring me the head of Chris Matthews. Because he was this hissing viper along with Ariana Huff and Puff, that sneering, snotty Andrea Mitchell, that witch Candy Crowley, you know.
Yes.
I'm making a documentary, and I'm hoping to run into one of them.
All right.
And, you know, if they walk away or slap me, that'll even make a better doc. If I find them, I'm going to ask them, how could you put her down that way, a woman?
Now, my last question for you. You said you're looking forward to Bill Clinton's speech. What will you be listening for?
How in the world he's going to stand up there and make believe he's enthusiastic about the ticket. I mean, we know there's going to be so many layers from his heart and his head that he's buttons he's going to try to touch, but we know that he's going. I don't know if I can do that. Well, let's go. You know, that's going to be one of the greatest political speeches, most interesting political speeches in history.
Right. Well, we will look forward to it tomorrow.